circuit and a voltage at the circuit. First one, the an electric circuit consists of various types of elements connected by the connector. Here we have just for example for the open circuit. The example is like this, and then you have the figure that just shows the short circuit. Short circuit, we get that there is two endpoints of the conductor, and then there is there is the current flowing through this conductor. But here we see that there is no current flowing because it is not connected. So here we have for the second one is current, and then we know that the current is the time rate just of the flow of electrical charge. This is the charge through the conductor or the circuit element. Here we just have two forms of current. We can just find the direct current, and then this is the figure that shows how the direct current goes through for the charge against time. And then here we have another form of current called alternating current, which is called AC, as known famous. And then you have a charge against the time, and then the alternating current flows this flow of current. For this current, we just have to know how we can just get this current through this resistor, and then we understand that if there is current for current AB, I can say there is positive terminal here, there is negative terminal, and then we say that this will be equal and just the same magnitude but different in the direction. It means this is equal to this, but the direction is different. This means it is in a negative direction to this current. For the voltage, here the voltage is the energy transferred per the unity of the charge that flows through the element. We get this voltage, we see that it is the voltage per unity flow, and then we will get the final formula that the voltage is equal to resistance times current. This will be the general formula, and then we know that also for the current is equal to voltage over resistance. Then we will just get in it's just a law. Just say the power will equal to the voltage times current. Then we can just hence get the unity of power. Then we know that the voltage is joule per coulomb times the ampere. Here the unity of current is ampere. Here also it is equal to joule per coulomb times coulomb per second. We know that the ampere, it is rate of charge per the time, and then here we get this coulomb will be simplified, and then we get joule per second, and then this will be equal to what we call what it is, the power, the unity of power. We get the power, and then the power, it is negative, it is the positive, it means the energy is being absorbed by element. And then if it will be like the battery, it means the battery will be charging another element. And then here, for the negative power, means the energy is being supplied by element. It means if it can be like the power, the battery, it means the power is charging something, it is supplying to energy to that device. The example for the finding the power, then we are going to do this example. Let's see, here there is 2 ampere following from the positive terminal to negative terminal. Here it follows through the 12 voltage, and then it means here we have the current equal to 2 ampere, and then we have voltage A equal to 12 voltage, and then power will be equal to voltage times current, which is equal to 2 times 12, and then the solution is 24 volt. It means the here it is just what the unity of power, and then it means because the power, it is positive, it means here energy absorbed. If it would be like the just the here there is the battery, it means it is charging. And then let's do exercise B. Then here we have the given, the current is flowing in this direction. It means it is from negative terminal up to positive terminal. Then here it will give us VB is equal to negative 12 volt. And then IB, here the current, it is 1 ampere. Then power B is equal to 12 volt times 1 ampere. This will give us negative 12 watt. And then we just get it is negative. This means energy is being supplied by an element. Here we are going to just look for the Kirchhoff's current law. And then the Kirchhoff's current law states that we have the sum of current in minus sum of current out will be equal to zero, which states that the net current entering or leaving a node is zero. This is what we call Kirchhoff's current law. Yeah, just we have the example to just see how we will just say we will just apply this Kirchhoff law. Here let's say Kirchhoff current law, how it will be equal for A. It means here there is entering a current one, then this is leaving one. It means we will just subtract I3, and then this is entering. It means it will be plus, then it will be equal to zero. Let's see for DZ B. Here there is entering current I1. Here it is leaving the node I2. It will be equal to zero. Then also for to apply here the Kirchhoff law. It means here there is entering one. We can just say it is negative current one. Here there is also the entering one, can just give it negative sign, is equal to I2. Here there is also entering, and here I3 is equal to zero. And then here there is negative, it means this negative can be removed, and then we remain with current one plus current two plus current three is equal to zero. This can be solution for this because it is entering for node, not even current we have. For the Kirchhoff voltage law, it means the algebraic sum of the voltage equal to zero for any loop in an electrical circuit. It means for here, the sum of voltage in the circuit must be equal to zero, and here we start to the one, and for all the number of voltage we have in the circuit. Here, just for applying voltage law, we must know that from negative terminal to positive terminal, we will just subtract for the voltage. Then if we move from positive terminal to negative terminal, we will add the voltage. So let's see the example of the circuit with the resistance A, resistance B, resistance C, resistance D, resistance E. Then how can you just find the going to apply this equation? We say that from negative to positive, it is just we will subtract, and then if we have from positive terminal to negative terminal, we will add. Here we start from the negative to positive. It means we will just subtract voltage A. Then here there is from positive to negative, means we will add voltage B. Then here there is from
or the direction will continue from positive to negative diminishes plus, then this will be equal to zero. Then let's see for the loop two. Loop two, we start from this point, and then we see that from negative to positive, it is just negative voltage C, and then here from negative to positive, it means there is negative VB, then here from positive to negative, it is plus voltage E. This is equal to zero. This is how we can just apply the Kirchhoff voltage law into the circuit. Two loops. Then you can add another loop outside here, like this. Then you can call it loop three. Then how we do for the loop three? We see that we can just start at any point we want. Then let's start for this point. If we start from this point, we see we have taken any direction you want. Even you can take anti-clockwise, clockwise, whatever. Here you can say that from negative terminal to positive, it is just negative voltage E. And then here from positive to negative, we'll just add voltage D. And then here, this rope direction of rope flowing from negative to positive, there is negative voltage B. And then here, it means here there is from positive to negative, we will add. And then here we will reach, here there is no resistance, here there is no resistance, we will return to the starting point. It means here we will get the zero, because sum of the voltage will be equal to zero.